You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Both defenses will have to be on the watch for a pair of tight ends looking to find seams in the secondary. It's Tammy's Falcons going up against Ertz's Eagles. With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Atlanta Falcons and the Philadelphia Eagles. Hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we saw Larry focus on the tight end matchup in his open. You think it's one to watch, don't you?
Definitely one to watch because these guys can create such big plays by all the different things they can do. Line up out wide, in the slot, line up in a normal tight end position, and then who are you going to cover them with? Is it a linebacker, a defensive back? They create mismatches all throughout the game.
Caleb Sturgis now to do the honors and get us started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. The Atlanta Falcons coming out here, and Matt Ryan and these guys have had some close games the last 3 weeks. They pulled out the Week 8 game against Green Bay. Matt Ryan, 32nd game-winning drive he's orchestrated, most since he entered the league in 08.
Really doesn't surprise us, though, coming from him, does it? Always maintains his cool, his poise, but they needed that as a team in a big way because the previous 2 weeks, close games, but they didn't get the wins. Loss at Seattle and at home in overtime to San Diego. Beating a quality opponent like Green Bay in the fashion that they did, that should really elevate their confidence.
Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. Now Ryan on first down. It's caught over the middle. Hooper. And they'll get him down here at the 23. Call it a gain of 5, and it'll be second down. Here's the offense, and we talk about the tight end, Jacob Tammet.
A lot of people thought of him as simply a safety valve receiver. He can be a primary receiver. Jacob Tammet shows better athleticism than what people expect.
Play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan toward the sideline, and look at that catch, dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
If you're running out route, it's likely you're going to end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice: toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. On first and 10, it's Ryan. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it, or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. Hits his target, it's Taylor Gabriel. So not much to speak of scoring-wise in this first quarter of play. It's a tight game here early, and we're back to Philadelphia after this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number 2. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Throwing now, Ryan on first down. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And we are back here. I'm Brandon Gunn alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes a timeout. And now we're set to get going. Welcome back, the offensive unit. They took the timeout, and now they get set to line up as we resume action. Now the Eagles will go with an extra DB here as they prepare for a stop on third.
Thinking pass all the way.
On third down, Ryan. And that's caught by Tammy. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. And how about this first drive? They're being aggressive, slinging it around.
Really confident, too, because they're not trying to fool them with running plays, throwing it, and they're being very successful right now.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. He goes underneath to Freeman. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 15 yards on the pickup there. And it'll give the Falcons a first down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. From the right hash, it's a 41-yard attempt. And the 14-year trusty veteran able to knock it through. And the Falcons are out to a 3-0 advantage. So they kick it through to take the lead. There is a little bit of time left, though, here in the second quarter.
And while they're concerned about not giving up a big return or giving up points themselves going into the half, how good do they feel, though, putting points on the board themselves right near the end of the first half?
Here's Bosher to kick it away. This is taken at the 3. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. A final shot before half for Wentz. And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete. So we've hit halftime. Just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
So let's take a look at the highlights from the first half. Midway through the second quarter, Ryan's got the completion out of the gun, and the play will come to an end after a gain of 15. Falcons would settle for 3 points on the drive. So that'll do it for us. We'll go back now to Philadelphia for the second half.
Okay, Larry, thank you. Just a lone field goal in that first half. Will the offenses show up? That's now the question. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is fielded a couple yards deep. It'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. And out now come the Eagles. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Second half starts with a run by Ryan Matthews. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Second down following the run. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. It's a 5-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we played three quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point, just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. He's back to throw. And that is incomplete. He was looking for Dorial Green Beckham. And that'll bring up a fourth down. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
Watch it now, Barney, Barney.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. So spinning away. Ryan Matthews, he's at the 30. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow, wow. How many practices have we watched over time where the offense works on scoring late in the game and finding a way to win, as we just saw there?
Just saw it right there. Now can they preserve that advantage that they just got? Caleb Sturgis now for the point after. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. Now after the touchdown, it's Sturgis to send it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
One complete to Mohamed Sanu, and he's brought down after a good gain. And a nice gain of 21 yards, and they're going to speed things up here. He'll look to throw. He's got time in the pocket, and it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Back to throw. He's going to let it fly. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver, and it's third down.
And that play was what every defense is wary of. The big strike attempted downfield, but they were in excellent position. They didn't get fooled, and while he didn't come up with the interception, was able to bat the ball down.
Ten yards to go on third. One receiver left, three to the right. They'll look to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Incomplete. And we're down to 8 seconds now.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Down four late, got to go for it here on fourth down. Here we go, it's Ryan on fourth down. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
And that one? Oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw, and it'll wind up being intercepted.
Defense still with three timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them here as the kneel down comes. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. Well, Charles, the old saying, the old cliche, if you will, points at a premium. That certainly applied here, didn't it?
And that almost like opened up a time capsule, didn't it? Old school football, low scoring, close game. What a way to finish it up.
You loved it, didn't you?
I certainly did.
The defenses.
I certainly did. Brought back the images of the game of old.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. The